Hey guys, this week's episode of the Evolve Weekly is about answering some of the most recent questions we've been seeing across our social media channels. So we've been getting a lot of questions about have we tested and tried any other battery types, in particular the 18650 cell. So the reason why we don't use the 18650 cell is because we would need at least 40 of those cells to make up one big battery like this. Here at Evolve, we use the flat pack lithium ion cells. So we use 10 of these cells to make up one full battery. As you can see, 10 of these cells, there'll be less soldering, less wires. Much easier to maintain. If ever there's a cell problem, we can easily replace that cell with another one and fix the battery. We feel it's a much safer option than offering 40 cells with many more solder joints and many opportunities for things to go wrong. We test these battery cells vigorously so we can get international certifications for our batteries across all our markets. Before we launched our GT carbon fiber skateboards, we did test out a bunch of other battery structures and cell types, one of them including the 18650 cell. So during our testing phase, we did experience a catastrophic battery failure in that 18650 cell. So because of this, we decided not to use that type of battery structure as well as the 18650 cell. Instead, we wanted to focus on new battery technology for our GT boards. We've designed our GT board's electric system to be able to handle massive current. In fact, it can handle between 60 to 80A at any given time, especially when you first start off going up a hill or over grass. A huge amount of power is needed to push the skateboard. With that amount of current going through the battery, voltage drop will be much faster in a smaller battery, such as our Bamboo GT battery, as you can see here, these are the cells. So voltage drop will be much faster in this cell compared to our carbon GT battery, which is almost twice the size. Voltage drop will be much less in a larger battery than a smaller battery. The reason for this confusion, we believe, is because we show the battery data and percentage in real time. So the reason why we show the battery percentage in real time is because it gives the rider specific battery information and it allows them to understand how much power they are actually using in real time. So having this information available allows you to really fine tune your riding style given the terrain you're actually riding on. GT mode is our max current mode. It uses the most amount of current when accelerating heavily on hills or through grass. If you were to use fast mode, for instance, you would be using half the amount of current draw compared to the GT mode. So that's a great little tip for you if you don't want to reduce the current and voltage as fast. We've also got an auto eco function set on our remote. This will come on when the battery percentage gets below 5%. However, it will not come on until you actually let the trigger go. So if you're going up a steep hill and you see the percentage drop below 5%, it may even go to 0%, it won't kick into eco mode until you let that trigger go. The reason why we designed the auto eco function is because if you're going up a steep hill and it was getting really low on voltage, you don't want the board to turn off, to lose complete power and get thrown off the skateboard. Instead, you can continue riding up the hill and then it will automatically go to a safer eco mode and allow you to then continue riding and get home. So since the one board launch a few months ago, we've listened to all your feedback and we've modified our one motor to be made from CNC steel internals. If you're a one board owner and you have any dramas with your motor, just reach out to us and we can replace it for you with the new version. Now for the GT motors. We have tens of thousands of these out there circulating in the community. Whilst we have issues with less than 1% currently that's out there, we are constantly improving the product and we've got some exciting news to share with you in regards to advancements of our GT motor, in which we'll share with you in a couple of weeks' time. So we've seen recently some evolved copycat knockoffs potentially coming to the market. Now, we were the first electric skate brand to bring out carbon fiber electric skateboards with built-in electrics, such as this. We've won good design awards for this board as well. We do have IP protection in place across all of our international markets, so this does limit where knockoffs can be sold from. But when you're buying an evolved board, you are actually buying into a brand that's committed to innovation, to customer service, to after-sales service. There is a community behind our brand, and we are run by skaters. Everyone is passionate who's involved, from all our international distributors to our community. So when you buy an Evolve board, you're buying into the Evolve family. Thanks for watching, guys. We've got some exciting updates coming soon, so stay tuned and look forward to seeing you next time.